Welcome to the series Master eComposer Elements. Today's video will show you in detail how to use an Instagram element on any page using eComposer. The Instagram feature is crafted to smoothly blend the social network into your page, boosting your conversion rate. Utilize this tool to showcase social proof for your store and products or to introduce your brand's social media pages to visitors. It's a handy way to keep your customers in the loop, and it also works wonders in attracting new followers. Before we start, don't forget to hit the thumbs up and subscribe button for our channel. If you don't have a Shopify account, feel free to click on the link we attached in the description below. The newest Shopify exclusive deal is waiting for you. Now, go to the Shopify dashboard, select App, and open eComposer Page Builder. In case you haven't installed the app, you can find the link to eComposer on Shopify App Store in this video description. Now choose an existing page that you want to add Instagram element. You can also create a completely new page by clicking the Start Building button here. Welcome to eComposer Editor. At the Element tab, find Instagram element and drag and drop it into the position you want. First, to show your images from Instagram, you must connect your Instagram account with eComposer. Please click Connect here. At the Social Connections section in pop-up, select Connect. Next, I will log in my Instagram account. Then select Save Settings. Thus, I have successfully connected my Instagram account to eComposer. Now, the images from my Instagram will be here. I will continue through the available settings to make the Instagram element look better. With the layout, I can choose the mesh layout or slider. When I choose a layout, you can see the corresponding options of that layout are displayed below. Image links have three options. None is not linked to your image. Media link is that you can click on each image to view the full image. Instagram post means you will be redirected to the same post on Instagram. Next is the maximum items to show. You can change the maximum number of images to display. It will display the latest images. If you want to turn on the background color covering your image, please tick Enable Overlay here. If you choose the slider layout on the General tab, you will see the Slider Settings tab shown right below. In this tab, there are many options to configure your slider. The option names are easy to understand, so you don't need to worry about them. Next, let's go to Design tab. Design tab is divided into two sections, Image va Navigation. The image options allow you to change the width, height, opacity, border radius. Watch the below video for the details. And navigation is very flexible. You can change the size, color, background, border, border radius, and distance for navigation in pages. Okay, now, I will add heading above to make this Instagram section look more friendly and accessible to customers. To finish editing, I need to save and publish this page. Alright, I have successfully added an Instagram section to my page. Let's check it out. that is the end of today's video. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment or join the eComposer community to get quick support and the latest updates. I'm putting the details in the description below. And don't forget to subscribe to our channels to receive the newest e-commerce page building tips and tricks. See you next time.